NASA and Dead Sea Scrolls weigh in on the God Comet. You don't want to miss a single thing coming from this video, everybody, because the data seems to indicate that the stuff is about to hit the fan and we are about to be caught up to meet Jesus in the air. Greetings, my brothers and sisters in Christ. This is Bob Barber here with your next Last Trump Report. And by the way, if you need a Bible, you don't have access to one, can't afford one, whatever the reason is, we can help. Email us, I need a Bible, to support at feedmysheeptoday.org. Include your full address and what country you're from, and we'll send you out a free Bible, free shipping anywhere on earth just for you. And plus, we are also giving away an additional gift to all of our wonderful subscribers here that support this channel. We are offering a Left Behind informational packet. And this informational packet is actually a flash drive loaded with many gigabytes of information that will be useful in the event you're left behind or your friends or family are left behind. And now they're scared and don't know what to do next or whatever. This may make all the difference in the world for them. So make sure to get yours today. And don't just get it and sit on it. Get it and start sharing it with all your loved ones. So if you're interested in receiving this, please just click the link below. You can watch a video that explains the whole thing. And before we get started, everybody, please just hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any new content that we have coming out. And everybody, don't forget to subscribe to our backup channel in the event that something happens to our YouTube channel here. Plus, subscribe to our free website at edvforme.org, where you have access to all of our videos, our Dream and Vision forums, and much, much more. Just enter in your email and you're good to go. And also, you can follow us on Parler, Rumble, MeWe, and YouTube. Links will be in the description box below. Greetings, my brothers and sisters in Christ. This is Bob Barber here with the next Last Trump Report. This week, everyone, we're going to continue talking about the evidence of the God Comet, what the scientific world has to say about it, and also how the Dead Sea Scrolls may be pointing to this event. And we begin to enter into ground zero when we enter debris tail around Passover this year. We are going to enter into a gigantic plasma storm, because if you haven't been watching my videos before this one, the God Comet is not your everyday normal comet. It's not like Halley's Comet where you have all that ice debris and stuff like that within its tail. No, this is a electromagnetic supercharged plasma ball traveling through our solar system right now, and the reports indicate that it's twice the size of the Earth, if not bigger. In my last week's video, I talked about how this plasma ball has been affecting all the other planets, causing the cores to heat up, and this is why we're having all the earthquakes and volcanic activity, seismic activity, sinkholes, and mass animal die-offs, birds losing their direction because the electromagnetic pole is being affected by this thing. The governments of the world have been getting ready for it. This is why they've been pushing the whole COVID-19 narrative. And it's a very weak narrative. You could punch all kinds of holes in this thing. We all know the math isn't adding up at all for any of this stuff. You got a virus here that has a 99.9% survival rate. They weren't able to put out a massive virus to take everybody out, and that really wasn't their plan in the first place. Plus, God wouldn't allow it. So they put out some weak virus, and to give it more meat and credibility, they took all the flu cases and cold cases throughout the year and added them to the COVID numbers. This is why flu cases dropped by 98% last year. Not too obvious, but okay. And don't forget all those unfortunate people who died from COVID because they got ran over by a car, or killed by a shotgun, or impaled by a unicorn while they're trying to hug a rainbow.
We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
Okay, so you know this thing's all garbage. Anybody that died of anything got added to the COVID numbers. Plus, on top of all that, they're forcing everybody to wear masks everywhere they go. And we all know, none of that mask wearing does anything for you at all. They're doing all this right now for control, yes, but I believe they're also doing this right now to bring the world into a position where everybody's sheltering in place. This whole thing creating the environment so they can move forward and begin passing legislatures and all kinds of rules and laws that gives them control of all the world's resources, from the money, the food, all the precious metals, everything. And at the same time, Give them the authority to put their boot on your neck. So that way, when we enter this debris tail, you won't be able to do anything. Can't fly here, can't fly there, can't travel here or there. You need a vaccine to get on this and that. The whole world COVID-19 campaign was brilliant. Now, let's get into more evidence of the God Comet, aka Planet X.
Planet X, the fiery red dragon of old, Nemesis, Nibiru. Is it all an internet hoax, or is it actually part of ancient and biblical prophecies?
Not until the last 3 days of its approach will it ever look threatening or large to the eye. Not until the last 3 days of its approach will it ever look threatening or large to the eye.
For years, this subject matter has been debated, argued against, and denied.
You have not seen this new planet.
No one has actually seen this planet.
But only the wise make it to the place of safety. The foolish don't.
Find out what rabbis, pastors, scientists, and the media are all saying of whether or not this mysterious body is entering our neck of the woods.
In a year, sir, this star will be clear for 40 days, and then the Mashiach will be shown.
Are the events that are happening on a global scale foretold in the Bible?
So we have not four, not seven, not eight, we have nine signs in the sky. There is no other generation that has had so many.
Two scientists claim that they have found the best evidence yet that a huge ninth planet exists at the outer limits of the solar system. It's called Planet X, and it's about 10 times the mass of Earth, or roughly the size of Neptune. But don't get too excited yet. No one has actually seen this planet. The entire argument about its existence is theoretical. It's based on the observations of six objects in the Kuiper Belt, the large cloud of icy bodies at the edge of the solar system. The way these objects move around the sun seems to indicate that they're being affected by something big, aka Planet X. Still, experts agree that the models supporting Planet X are strong.
Now, this is Gil Brizard right here, whose research that makes up the majority of what I've been showing you for the most part. And he said something very interesting in this video right here. He said that you won't be able to see this comet coming until about 3 days, give or take, before we enter its debris tail.
Not until the last 3 days of its approach will it ever look threatening or large to the eye.
And this is what I showed you in a thumbnail, where you will see the comet streaking across the sky at sunset to the upper left of the sun as it's going down. This is where Gil Brizard said you'll be able to spot this comet right around Passover. It doesn't get any more clear cut than that. So if what Gil said here is true, then when you see this thing, you better get your dancing shoes on, because there's a good chance that we might be going home. Because if you watched the last Trump report from last week and the week before, I talked about how when we enter into this debris tail of electromagnetic plasma energy, there will be enough energy surrounding the Earth, pelting the Earth from this God comet, for God to initiate and complete the rapture resurrection of the church. Because of the pull of electricity the Earth will be submerged in during this time, we all know that electricity definitely plays a role in the regeneration of our bodies.
Lord Jesus, we thank you for the food we're about to receive. We pray for Frank, Marianne, and Beth. Protect them, watch over them in this hour of need. We pray for Josh McManus, the man you sent to protect them. Be merciful for all those who have lost their way, Lord. We pray that everyone will see the light of your glory.
Dad!
What? Pearl.
I love making videos like that. So you get the idea. When we enter this electromagnetic plasma superstorm, the Earth will be pelted and surrounded by immense amounts of electromagnetic plasma energy, which will supply all the power God needs to initiate the rapture resurrection event. Now, the Earth is about 75% water, and we know water is a great insulator for electricity. But it also is a great conductor because of all the salt that's in the water. And since the Earth is surrounded by water for the most part, yeah. And to prove my point, I'm going to share a video with you right now that we received from our friend Andy, screen name Firefly. And it talks about how salt water can be converted and used as electricity very easily. Now, the video is about 10 minutes long, so I edited it down, but I just want to give you a quick understanding of how water is not just a great insulator of electricity, but in the right environment, is also a great conductor of electricity. And we know the Earth will be covered in plasma energy when we enter into this debris tail of this comet, and it just so happens the name of this man's channel here is the Plasma Channel.
Water has incredibly useful electrical properties. Salt water, for example, is conductive. Hey, I'm Jay, you're watching Plasma Channel. Now, that dichotomy can be really useful, and you can hack it to create your own miniature lightning. With just a few cups of water, some salt, and some plastic aquarium tubing, and about 30 or 40 minutes of your time, you can have hundreds of thousands of volts right at your disposal. So grab yourself a cup, because you're about to see water's true potential. Kinda crazy, right? Just a few glasses of water and some hardware and some plastic tubing, and you've got a 100,000 volt power supply. And keep in mind, two of the three main components are primarily made of water.
And if you haven't noticed, you look around the world, we are surrounded by water. Now you're wondering, what does NASA have to say about the God Comet, about Planet X? And basically, they know about it, but they're going to completely deny it, okay? And we know they found it back in 1980, and they were studying it and researching it and going after it, and then all of a sudden they just decided to stop doing it, and then they shut down the research program about it around the early 90s. At least that's what they said. And instead of trying to explain it away, they just decided to claim that it just doesn't exist. And I have a video I'm going to show you right here. This is David Morrison. He's a scientist at NASA. And he came forth with his own research about it. And I guess it scared a bunch of people. So the powers that be forced him to backpedal on his research and forced him to claim that Planet X just does not exist.
Hi, my name is David Morrison. I'm a NASA space scientist. And I want to talk to you very briefly about Nibiru.
If you couldn't understand him, he just said Nibiru, or Planet X, the God Comet.
I'm doing this because I received a note from a 12-year-old girl recently.
One, nice hesitation, and two, they always use children to explain the truth or to give fluffy content to their wicked agendas.
Yet, you all come to us young people for hope. How dare you? How dare you?
I guarantee you this, it was not a letter from a 12-year-old girl. It was a letter from his masters, the word leet. Let's watch that hesitation again as he tries to sell this thing. Not buying what you're selling, pal.
I'm doing this because I received a note from a 12-year-old girl recently that said she wondered if the video I made 2 years ago was still valid.
He put out a video that covered all his research and findings about Planet X.
That she and her classmates were scared about Nibiru, and could I please explain, from a science point of view, why we know Nibiru is not real and is not a danger? You know, the simplest thing to say is just that there is no credible evidence whatever for the existence of Nibiru. There are no pictures, there's no tracking, there's no astronomical observations. There really isn't any evidence here to counter, but I can quite specifically say how we know that Nibiru or Planet X does not exist and does not threaten the Earth.
Yeah, we believe you. So there's your answer, everybody. NASA just flat out denies it exists. And since they're just flat out denying it, that definitely confirms that it does exist. Friends, I got good news for you. The time's almost at hand. We're about to go home and rapture resurrection. It's almost time to leave, which means the time window is now closing for you to build up your eternal rewards in heaven that you will receive at the Bema Seat Judgment. Rewards that will dictate how you and your family will live forever. So are you out there preaching the saving grace gospel of Jesus Christ? 1 Corinthians 15:1-4. You need to be out there in the streets, you need to be knocking on doors, you need to be speaking to large crowds, you need to be talking to everybody everywhere you go. Have you been doing that? I would say probably most of you have not. And that's okay, because many of you probably didn't know this, God has probably called you to be a seed sower and not a waterer that does all those things I just mentioned on a big scale. In 1 Corinthians 3:7-9, it talks about those who sow the seeds and those who water the seeds. It says that both of them have one purpose, and each will be rewarded according to their own labor. For we are co-workers in God's service. So the seed sower and the waterer are co-workers together on the same project. The same project that will reward them their eternal rewards. So are you a part of this one project? It doesn't matter if you're the sower or the waterer. Just get involved in the project. Question is now, do you want a lot of rewards or do you want a little? Do you want to plant a whole farm or just plant some pottery plants hanging off your window? Or maybe something in the middle? It's up to you. Either way, whatever you want to do, here at Feed My Sheep Today, we can make it happen for you in a big way, because we already have the infrastructure in place. Over the years, we have built a huge network of waterers, which are your Christian missionaries, all over the world. These missionaries are preaching the right gospel, they're doing all the right things, they are all established with us, they are all mobile, and they move all around their country. Everything's ready to go. All they need is just seed. So no matter what size seed you sow here, it is immediately spread out into all those high impact watering areas, the best fertile ground where nothing will be wasted, where you will see the maximum results of the growth of the body of Christ. And what our missionaries will do exactly is they will be purchasing and distributing KJV English Bibles, so the people that can't read English, and will also buy and distribute Bibles in their own native languages. And we will be distributing those Bibles for free to those who come to the belief in the saving grace of Jesus Christ. And those people will come to that belief through the preaching from the missionary and the missionary's team, and also through audio-visual presentations that will also be presented at those times that help explain the death, burial, resurrection of Jesus Christ and the gift of salvation that came with it. On top of all this, we will also be bringing food, water, blankets, medical supplies, all the humanitarian relief aid that we will need to help the people in these hard to reach areas. We're not going into the cities and all that stuff, everybody. We're going into those forgotten places where nobody wants to help these poor people who barely have enough money to put an extra shirt on their back. We come into these areas and we try to help these people as much as we can before the preaching begins, and that's just the right thing to do. On top of all this, Feed My Sheep Today also supports orphanages in many different countries throughout the world. you will be able to feed children, give them food, clothing, education, shoes, hygiene products, provide them beds, and much, much more. So there is so much going on right now in all the different facets of Feed My Sheep today. So when you sow your seed, you can be rest assured that great things will be generated from it. So all of you who have given before, please, we need your help right now. All you people who have never given before, this is what you do. You go to our website, feedmysheeptoday.org. Link is below. This is a very user-friendly website. Just choose how you want to give. You can give by PayPal, credit card, bank draft. Click on the amount you want to give or enter a custom amount. Or just simply send your gift in the mail. You want to make a real big difference over time? Then would you please consider joining our monthly sustainer program. You could change the world with just $10 a month. That will purchase 3 new Bibles for 3 new believers every month. Or perhaps you want to do more. That will be greatly welcomed. Any amount is so greatly appreciated here. And any of you out there that want to support the orphanages, please even consider giving $100 a month, because that amount will purchase a whole new bed for an orphan. This includes the frame, the mattress, the sheets, the blankets, the pillows, everything. Just go to feedmysheeptoday.org and everything you need is right there. And while you're there, check out the pictures, check out the videos, check out the articles, check out everything. And folks, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, where you can keep track of everything that's going on with the funding that comes into this ministry. You can change the world in a godly way, starting with Feed My Sheep today.
Thank you, Jesus. Feed my sheep today.
There is so much work that needs to be done. There are so many new people all around the world who have not yet been added to the body of Christ, and they needed to be added to the body of Christ before we leave. Because we are in the final hours, the numbers who are coming to hear the gospel of grace and receive aid and their free Bibles have greatly increased exponentially during this time. We're just hoping now to see our support increase, be able to keep up with the demand. Because once we're called up to the clouds, our work is done here on the earth. So we're all only going to get one chance to do this, everybody. So don't miss out on the potential eternal rewards that you can receive from the works of God that can be manifested through your support of this ministry. So everybody, thank you all so much for your support, and may God bless you all. Now, I have an interesting clip I want to share with you guys. This is from Stephen Ben-Dannoun from Israeli News Live. And in this video, he discovered something in the Dead Sea Scrolls that may have a great connection with the coming God comet, Planet 7X.
Very, very, very serious message today here, friends. And a discovery I made in the Dead Sea Scrolls. In the Qumran Scrolls, I came across a fragment recently. It's fragment 4Q558. It's called The Vision, is the name of that fragment. And it's a very small fragment, but it is very obvious that they are referring to Malachi's prophecy that we're going to be speaking about here, the judgment itself. Malachi 4:1 for those King James Version or regular New Testament Bible holders. So let me take you first to this fragment here, and I'll post it on the screen for you so you can see it. I'll photograph it here. And the fragment states in line 3, the 8th is an elected one, and C, I, and then we go to line 4, to you I will send Eliah.
Eliah, by the way, if you didn't know, is Elijah.
Before, okay, and then there's a blank spot, which if we look at the before, we know from Malachi chapter 4 there that it's before the great and dreadful day of the Lord. But, and this is not a Malachi writing, but it's quoting the same thing. But in line 5, power, lightning, and meteors. Yeah, you heard exactly what I just said. Power, lightning, and meteors. So the great destruction of Malachi chapter 4 that is spoken about when Elijah the prophet comes, is to bring about a destruction of lightning and meteors. It also reflects here in Malachi 4. He says, behold, I will send you, Eliah, actually, just like we see in the Dead Sea Scrolls here, Eliah the prophet, before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. So this dreadful day that will burn up all the Nephilim bloodlines and those that have grafted themselves into their lineage is going to be destroyed. We know how now, according to the Dead Sea Scrolls, by power, lightning, and meteors. How many of you remember when I was giving you an intel briefing one time, I spoke to you not only about the fact that they said meteors are coming, that this binary system that's passing through, which by the way, is believed to be every about 3,600 years, it is believed to be what passed during the time when Moses and all the plagues that hit Egypt. But it's believed that that's what's coming now, the exact same binary system that passed 3,500, 3,600 years ago is what's coming now. And only this time is to be far more destructive. As I've even been told that we have outer bands coming again towards the earth in April and May, somewhere around there. And then again, another band will come through. But the other thing that I was told as well is that we would also experience what is called plasma lightning.
Water has incredibly useful electrical properties. Salt water, for example, is conductive.
Hey, I'm Jay. You're watching Plasma Channel. Kind of crazy, right? Just a few glasses of water and some hardware and some plastic tubing, and you've got a 100,000 volt power supply. And keep in mind, two of...
as a result of this binary system. And that's when the ozone layer has absorbed all this energy from this system, that it stretches the ozone layer out, and then it releases a lightning strike from it. And it is believed by scientists that this is one of the ways the Grand Canyon may have been created in one day, was from a plasma lightning strike. And I was told that that type of lightning will knock a hole in the earth as deep as the Grand Canyon. So before we rush to judgment and say, oh, these things are just ludicrous, Steve, you're saying that we're going to get hit by asteroids, meteorites, or whatever the case may be. And I've often quoted from Revelation, well, there's going to be stones, hailstones, that are going to hit the earth the weight of a talent. I know there's different ideas of how heavy that is. I've heard different thoughts on that. 100 pounds is what I basically remember. Maybe wrong on the weight, but still, that's some pretty doggone big stones. But I did not realize, just in memory, that also in Revelation, it's lightning and hail, just like in the Dead Sea Scrolls.
So folks, there you are. Please comment. Let us know what you guys think about this research. There is more content coming up. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, because we have more evidence. We have more stuff to show you as we near the time of Passover and the potential appearing of this comet. Because remember, Gil Brizard said that we will not be able to see this comet until about 3 days out before we enter its debris field. So stay tuned, everybody, and may God bless you all. Hang in there, for we are almost finished. Amen. Amen.